If you found this video, that means that you are asking yourself, what is Lightroom and why should I be using it as a photographer? Well, let me just tell you, I'm going to save you hours, days, weeks, months, years of research just by watching this 5-minute video on Lightroom. And as a bonus, I'm going to give you 5 steps towards best practices for digital workflow on how to edit your photo on Lightroom. So let's start. Everybody, I am Giselle Behrens for Photo TV NYC, and this is a community of photographers giving you the best tips and tools to make amazing photos. We're going to go ahead and start our import process, and we're going to go to our left-hand side where we have the sources. Locate today's photo, which is right here. On the right, we're going to have all of the file handling and the apply during import, which are presets that you can add to your photos directly from the get-go. When it opens up in Lightroom, it's going to direct you to library, and in library, we're going to have our little thumbnail in the center area of the photos that were imported. On the left, we're going to have the navigator, catalog, all of the folders, which are the locations where our folders and photos actually live. Then we have our collections and publishing services, which you can sync and directly share from Lightroom to any of the publishing services that are available. On the right, we have our histogram, quick develop, which are some quick editing tools. Then we have our keywording, which you can just quickly add. Afterwards, you have your metadata as well as some comment area. And finally, on the bottom area, we're gonna have all of our film strip with the previews that we just imported, as well as our rating system for colors, labels, flagging, unflagging, rejected, and all the good stuff. This first step is crucial to getting organized because the more organized we are, the quicker we're gonna work. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a collection. We're going to go to our develop module, and on the left-hand side, we have the navigator, our presets, snapshots, history, and all of the collections. And on our right, we have all of our editing tools as well as the histogram and our correcting tools. We're going to jump into our correcting tools, starting with lens correction. So we're going to make sure that enable profile corrections is on to remove any distortion from the barrel of the lens and the camera. We're going to remove any chromatic aberration just to make sure that these horrible and magenta lines don't appear. You can reduce the noise under the tab of detail as well as adjust the sharpening. If you want to correct the perspective of your photo, you can go to transform and select auto, or you can play with your manual controls. On this step, you can also use the spot removal, red eye correction, and the cropping tools to correct your photograph. We can see Lightroom as the digital version of a darkroom, so any adjustments we did in the darkroom, we can do in Lightroom, and editing is where it shines the most. We are going to be adjusting our highlights, our tones, and our shadows to make sure that our photo looks as good as it can possibly get. So if you are working with a raw photo, that means that you have the most control over your image and the adjustments. For example, you can see how much sky and clouds we recovered on this photo because it was taken with RAW. If you want to know why you should be shooting in RAW and the difference between editing a RAW file and a JPEG, watch this video over here that I'm linking in. Now, Lightroom gives us a lot of general tools like the basic tab as well as the tone curves, as well as some masks that we can do. I did 2 linear masks to help with the water and the sky. And now I'm painting in darkness and brightness, which are the dodging tools and burning tools that Lightroom gives us to have full control over our photograph. Now we're gonna start getting creative with Lightroom. So we're gonna go ahead and paint. We're gonna select a nice warm orange just to enhance these colors that the sunrise already has. And once we're done, we're going to go to new, select a nice deep purple, which is very close to the blue one, just to enhance the sky and give it a little bit of a special touch. Lightroom has tons of tools that we can get creative with. For example, they have mask within a mask, They have linear and radial masks as well. You can also get creative with a spot removal tool. And if we go down to main tabs, we have HSL, which is hue saturation and luminance, split toning, effects, and in effects, we can add grain as well as play around with our post-vignetting effects. Here's our before and our after with only using Lightroom. Oh yeah, we're the captain of our ship because we are going to be selecting and deciding how we're going to be sharing this image. Are we going to export it and save a copy on our hard drive? Or if you do have an account set up and synced, you can directly share it with the publishing services. I'm going to go ahead and press export. I already have a preset done. You can select a preset or you can select multiple presets for this image to save and export. I already created one that is called Internet for Instagram. So we're going to have the location, file naming, video if it's a video, the file settings, the format, color space, quality, image sizing, if you want to sharpen this image when it is exported, all of the metadata options, if you do want to watermark it, and their post-processing options. I already have mine ready, set, and saved, so I'm gonna hit export, and when I do hit export, it saves it automatically in the location that I desired it to be saved at, and we can also batch edit and export multiple photos at the same time within Lightroom. Here's our before and after. Once we learn how Lightroom thinks and how it's structured, we can learn how to use it, and with practice, you will be doing these edits in minutes. There's no right or wrong way to use Lightroom. These are just a few tips and tricks that I've learned throughout 13 years of using Lightroom, and I hope that they were helpful to you.
Congratulations! Now you know more than many photographers out there about Lightroom. So hit that subscribe button because we are going to be learning how to use Lightroom on the next videos. So make sure to watch them and we'll see you there.